in terms of things that you'll see probably almost every shift, you'll see vomit, you'll see urine, you'll see people shit, you see blood, you see dog piss, you see dog shit, leftover rubbish that they vomited in, you see burger boxes that people have done a shit in. The list goes on, every disgusting thing you can think of. Most of the time, customers, you can just get them onto a train and you don't have to worry, but every now and then, a customer's a difficult case. I've seen people come through who've been stabbed with bottles, and I've seen women harassed and shouted at, as well as people fighting on platforms, pushing people, threatening to push people into the tracks. It can get pretty scary. I've been working on London Underground for 3 years. I started off as a station staff and now as a driver on one of the busiest lines on the Underground. On a normal night shift, I would start normally around 11 p.m. and then I would finish around 7 a.m. The training that you get on the Underground for starting on the stations is 5 weeks. Most of that is around the rules and procedures, dealing with evacuations, understanding how the ticketing works. You get an hour, 2 hours at most, being told how to deal with conflict. That training was designed for people who are working when there was no night tube. And actually, night tube workers deal with a lot more conflict. We're the ones who deal with often the most difficult customers. So after the pub door or clubs is kicked out and hundreds or thousands of people are flocking through the station, those platforms can get really busy and it's like an extension of the pub or the club, continuing onto the platform and then onto the train. One night in particular, there was a big fight right outside the station and someone ended up getting stabbed in the back of the head with a bottle. At that point, maybe 20 or 30 people turned up into the station, people with torn shirts, some of them covered in blood. The guy who'd been stabbed was trying to get down onto the platform. Me and a couple of other people were trying to stop him from moving. There was blood being smeared all over the walls at that point. More and more people were around us shouting. None of us really knew what had happened. People were fighting with each other. People were fighting with the police. We only had 3 of us there and 1 manager. The whole situation was really chaos. And that's on top of the fact that other people were still trying to use the station at the time. You have good nights and you have bad nights. The majority of people using the night tube are good, they just want to get home. But there's a significant minority, and on some nights it feels like almost everyone you deal with has got a problem with you and you're their target. Some of the people we deal with do seem like they're just intent on violence. People will threaten to stab you outside the station. People say that they'll push you in the tracks. Most of the time it probably is just threats, but you never know if any of those threats are actually going to be carried out. I've seen my colleagues attacked. I came off a break once and saw there was a disagreement between my colleague and someone else. And I found the guy had just pinned my colleague to the side of the lift with his hands around his neck. In that moment, you feel genuinely scared and you don't know what you're going to do. When it comes to verbal abuse, a lot of it is people saying that they pay your wages, you should just help them, or you're no good at your job, you don't know what you're doing. Other people call me a fat cunt, and, you know, eventually that can come and that can demoralise you. After the kidnap and murder of Sarah Everard, there was a lot more pressure to get the nightclub opened. The idea that the nightclub is a haven of safety is a bit of a myth. It's probably true that nightclub is safer than walking down the street, but equally, nightclub is a place where assaults happen all the time, where people do get attacked. And while it's good to say that it's well lit and well staffed, that's not necessarily the reality. You might be waiting 10, 15 minutes for a tube train, and that means people waiting on platforms, falling asleep. There have been problems at some terminal stations of men waiting around, looking for women that have been left alone on the tube or falling asleep. In almost every shift you work, someone will come up to you and say that someone's groped them, or tried to attack them, or said something sexually inappropriate to them. When I became a tube driver, that presented some different challenges. Now you can be responsible for maybe up to 900 people on your train. You're the only person between them and their next station. You'll get people messing about, looking like they might jump. People think that that might be funny, but it's not funny for anyone that's actually experienced someone jumping in front of their train. That probably happens maybe once a month for a driver. It's unfortunately all too common. And that's obviously very distressing. There are drivers who've unfortunately hit someone with a train more than once. I know people who've really struggled with their mental health afterwards, and even after they've sought support from colleagues and from professionals, they still struggle to this day with those memories. I think when people think about working on the underground, they often tend to just think that it's well paid, but they don't think about the toll that shift work takes on you. Night work is really tiring. You're forever having to cancel things with friends, partly because you're working, but also the next day or days after, maybe you're too tired to really do anything. Over years and years, that takes its toll. It takes 15% off your overall life expectancy. And if you've done this for 30 or 40 years, there's a long list of people that everybody knows on the underground who retired, and then maybe 6 months later, they were dead. I think at the moment, the future looks very uncertain. There are big cuts coming. Tired, fatigued, and stressed out drivers or station staff are not going to be able to provide the service that's needed to keep you safe. Overall, for tube workers, we just want everybody to treat us with respect in the way that we'd expect that we would treat them.